Thank you. Right.
She just opened the door and see if that helps.
Got, what was it?
Get to the party. Okay, let's
We'd like to welcome you all to Christa's 23rd birthday party.
24!
This is the 24th!
Christa and I are both turning 23 today.
Oh, there we go. A compromise,
huh? Averaging out
already. No, Christa is turning 24 today, but I'm also turning 23, which makes this a very nice day. You don't need to bring me presents. Just remember when you tell anybody how old your brother-in-law slash son-in-law is. He's 23 now. This is my.
Is she growing any wrinkles yet?
Beautiful wife without any wrinkles. Happy birthday.
Thank you, sweetie.
Old lady.
Yeah, you guys have been married, what, 7 months?
7 months and 2 days.
Woo!
Chris to get for her birthday.
Not much. So here's the real story, though, actually. Yesterday, I said, I'm going to give you a present, right? I didn't even say first thing, I don't think, but tomorrow before you go to work, maybe first thing I said.
Yeah.
She's like, no, I want to open it after work. Because that way, all day long, I'll have something to look forward to. So this morning, the alarm goes off. I turn over, I'm like, oh, sweetheart, happy birthday. First thing she says to me, she doesn't say thank you or happy birthday.
That's not too rude.
She said, I want to open my present now.
That's not true. I did.
And I said, are you serious? And she's like, yeah. I changed my mind. So before she even got out of bed, I went and got a present.
Chris declared,
that's not true. My demons boost him. Really? And then I decided. All right. That I wanted. Anyway, I'm glad I did because it made my whole day. Well, so what he does is he brings out this sack, and in the sack there's a big vanilla envelope.
But if you scratch and sniffed it, it smelled like that.
That's why it's called a vanilla
envelope.
Anyway, I open it up, inside there are three little ones, and they're labeled.
Weird.
Yeah.
He's a weird kid.
The one says, the story, open first. And the other one says, the present, open second. And then the third one says, the option open last. So, I open up the first one, the story. Oh, I should have.
You should have.
You tell them what it says in the story. You do it better.
It's your birthday.
All right. It says.
See if you would remember if they even left any sort of impression on you.
Remember back to last June when we were on the road going out to Cedar Hills to visit the new bride's family and have dinner. Remember what the husband says to the young bride as they travel? See, you can tell it better.
All right. No.
All right.
We just had. No, all right.
No, you go ahead.
I'm going.
No, tell it.
Talk. Well, one of you just tell a story.
Anyway, and the husband...
You don't have to try to recount it as if it's said.
Anyway.
Just tell
it. I'll give you the bottom line.
Reader's Digest version.
Right. Yeah. Dad's bored.
Well, this is a good story, so stop being bored.
I want to get to the meat of this. What's the present?
Anyway, so what it pretty much says is, remember back to we were dreaming, clear back last June. He said, if you had $500, what would you do with it? I'm like, ooh. Probably go up and stay an anniversary inn. I don't know, maybe drive around in a limo, eat at Lakai. I don't know, or maybe go to, can we go to Mexico for $500? Anyway, we were just dreaming. Anyway.
Krista's comment was, I sure wish that could happen sometime.
Yeah, I'm sure that happens sometime. Anyway, and so, didn't think of anything else of it. Anyway. So I open up the present, and there's a little white envelope.
The rules.
Oh, the rule.
Well, either way.
I'm going to open the present first. No, I'm not. I open up the little white envelope, and inside, there's $600 bills inside. $600 inside this envelope. And with it, there's a note that says that he didn't use any of his salary money at all. He got all those
4 years for that.
For mine. Thank you. He got all $600 by donating plasma and selling CDs and participating in research at BYU and just doing all the jobs. Right, just volunteering for other people's studies.
Cool.
Anyway, he got all $600. And anyway, so that it came with some rules. So I can't use it to pay any bills or anything that I would otherwise buy if I didn't have the $600. It has to all be for me, entertainment. It says I can't spend it on anybody, not even him, unless it's like participating in something with me, an activity like going out to eat or whatever. Anyway, and are there any rules left out? Anyway.
So what are you gonna do?
Your dad has to come along.
No, he doesn't.
That's all the rules. Rules. You can't bring your dad.
And then
I sure wish I had my pillow.
I opened up the last one. It was the options. Anyway, he put together this little booklet of things, you know, possibilities. If I wanted to, like, he had a thing from the internet for, like, limousines and Lakai. And also, my favorite one, I opened up, there was an anniversary and brochure in there, and I opened it up. Inside, there was a reservation.
Cool.
For the 26th. In the lighthouse room. You remember that, Buffy?
The one with the fish.
The fish. Yeah. Anyway. And so, and it actually turns out really nice because it's on a weekday, which makes it cheaper. And plus, Brigham got in the mail a thing for $50 off. So.
Wow.
It's going to be a lot cheaper than it usually is. Anyway, so I'm going to use part of my $600 for that.
Gee, just think. Krista, with your $600, you could buy Brigham a new computer.
Not the $200, to $800, you could get a real good computer.
He said it can't be practical kind of stuff.
Yeah.
You tell the rules.
Yeah, so I have like a thing in there and options for like Thomas Kincaid things.
Cool.
Oh my gosh, can you guys believe that?
$600. I knew about it from mom.
I don't think I've spent $600 on your mom's birthday presents from
26 years.
I still am in shock. I don't know quite what to do with it.
Oh, but she was just going ballistic, huh?
I was hysterical this morning.
I'll bet she was pleased. She's never gotten more than a $45 present in her life.
Well.
Not for your birthday.
It will happen again for a long time if it does.
And then, that's not even all, though. Then, I go start getting ready for work.
I do, too.
And I start to get ready for work, and I come out, and there's a candlelight breakfast. He's made crepes. We get to eat crepes for candlelight. And then, I make sure. And it kind of turned out really nicely because, you know, we went out to lunch with work. And Richard told me that Chad was going to stay after and help move stuff. I'm like, late for you there anyway.
I was there until it was time to go, pretty much. Not 4:15, but like 3:45.
Mm-hmm. So. Anyway, and so your thing's blinking. I don't know what that means.
It's going to go off, so. Oh, well, there's another battery, though. Keep talking.
Anyway, so he was going to let me go and then keep the guys there to help them move the stuff because they're going to paint and recarpet while we're gone. Anyway, so he's like, well, call Brigham and tell him to come get you about 1:30. I'm like, 1:30? He's like, yeah. I was like, I bet it would be later. But because the clients always take a while to leave and we couldn't go until they were all gone. So I call Brigham and tell him to come get me at 1:30. Says he'll be there. And then we didn't get out till later because the clients didn't leave till later. And anyway, so we get to the restaurant about 1 and order our food. And so I called Brigham, but I can't get a hold of him. Jamie, you're good, which is why I look so nice. And, anyway, so he came to pick me up at 1:30 and the food hadn't even come yet. So I ran over to Summit, which is just across the street from where we're eating, and grabbed him and brought him back, so he got to lunch with me. And Richard said he would, you know, was willing to buy lunch for Brigham too, but Brigham had already eaten a little bit, so he just helped me eat mine, which was nice because I could eat it.
Just took care of some beans and some rice.
Where was this place? What was this?
It's just near NC Town.
Sure, across the street.
I don't recommend it. I don't think it was that good.
It was fine. It wasn't the best. It wasn't the worst at Mexican food I've ever had.
Definitely fits in the middle here.
Yeah.
So what's in sin?
Well, since I got home, Brigham's family all came over. All of them except for Travis and Emily and Tana and David and their two kids. They all came over. Can't believe it. They brought like balloons. They brought a pumpkin cheesecake with them.
They came super late.
Some
of them stayed for 12 minutes.
Because Brigham had already had other plans and told them we're going to leave at 4. And they showed up at like 3:50.
I have a sweet sister-in-law that's just as good as they come, but it's just amazing.
Those like people we know.
She's great.
Anyway, so they all came and sang happy birthday, and we had the cheesecake really fast, and they...
Our little two-year-old niece sang happy birthday. Oh, thank you. She was awesome.
They gave me a couple of presents, which were really expensive, and... Yeah. I don't know how much they were, but the tag said $115. Hopefully it was on sale.
What was it?
A dress.
Cool. Wow.
Is that a good dress?
Like the bottom part, the fabric is awesome. Like I wish the whole thing was made out of it. On the top, there's like a large print.
Weird print. It's not even the same at all.
I've never really seen large print dresses and stuff that I really like very much, so.
Yeah. So that puts us in an awkward situation because neither one of us really liked the dress.
And they brought her another present, but that one got lost.
Yeah, it got lost. They're like,
maybe Simon took it out, or my little niece took it out when they were home or something.
They're like, look at the bottom of the bag, that's not all. And I'm like looking in the bottom of the bag, and there's nothing there. And I'm like, we're going to help. There's something I don't know about here. We're just like, it's love. We always put love in the bag. I'm like, oh, I feel love. Anyways, I feel love. Anyway, and then, so then we kicked them out. Brigham took me ice skating at 7 Peaks. That was really fun. Like, when we both get on the ice, it's been years since either one of us is gamer. We're like, whoa. These little 3-year-olds are passing us out. We were doing some tricks.
We were doing pair skating, little figure skating.
Yeah.
We're getting ready for the Olympics. We're thinking about trying to make a run at it.
Yeah, I think we got really good at crossing in front of each other.
Yeah, we do these weaves and switch hands. I pull from one over the other.
Yeah.
And do little spins.
We were good, huh?
Every once in a while, we stick out our hands.
We weren't very good.
And if the judges were there scoring, you would have got 1.9, huh?
I think we would have got anywhere near 1.9, perhaps.
I was going to take her to dinner, but we ate lunch at like 2 o'clock, and then we'd had cheesecake. I wasn't really hungry. And so, I bought myself my own birthday present. I bought those baked chips. So,
she really wanted the chips. There's any place in the world that you want to go there because you wanted her chips.
I want some chips. And so he just went to Subway and got some subs. We had a little coupon for it and got our sub and had subs and chips for dinner.
Life is good.
And then we came up here.
Party on! You did?
What kind of movies?
We got conflicts. We got The Mexican, that new Julia.
I've heard of it.
Yeah.
And then.
Have you seen it?
Time to Kill.
Bring up your cats and now I'm trying with one, sorry. Come on.
Oh, yeah. No,
what's in the box?
Sure keeps you from licking them.
It's a fresh girl.
That's ours.
But is your cat in your back one here? When do we start the left stuff, right? Yeah. I'm ready to start.
I didn't want to pour out another deal.
What?
Man, you were sick.
Body lotion.
A bag. What is it? It's
a fanny pack.
An apron.
A letter writer?
Cool, Christa. That's really nice. The wallet. What number was
spoken from personal experience, right?
Yeah.
Whoa, that's got some feeling. One more blow.
Well, it's set to record it for you.
Now it's recording. Here. I can still see one.
Okay, there we go. This is the year that Brigham optimistic thought the Easter Bunny was really going to deliver.
I can still see.
Well, we always see before
where
it gets
full. I know where some is that somebody hasn't got.
Think challenging.
Think like you're not two anymore. So there's my littlest lady.
I can still see some.
Very obvious.
Very obvious. Oh, I can still see some too. I know where some is that's not so obvious.
How do you know it hasn't already got it?
This
do they know? Because I've been watching.
March 30th, 2002. There we go. Right, I guess it is the 31st, isn't it?
To get some, you have to move something. To get others, you have to get down on your hands and knees.
I think we already got those times.
I'll bet you there's some that you'll never find unless I tell you where it is.
Maybe so.
Because the Easter Bunny's a better hider than you are a finder! Oh, don't move the couch by its cushions. You rip it apart.
Don't put it back where it was. Where it was. Just going.
We didn't move any couch. I mean, the Easter Bunny wouldn't have the strength to move the couches.
Don't move the couches.
Say this one.
So is that all?
I don't know. You won't leave, I'll tell you.
Oh!
That was a little slow to find that one, but it under the Christmas.
Forget these old tricks.
I haven't seen, you might have got them, but I haven't seen somebody get the ones that I think.
Yep. Okay, so forgetting the traditional hiding places. Gee.
What?
Pretty sure.
Hey, we don't already have them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Really, you don't have more space for anything anyway, so you might as well keep it up. She got one at church today for babysitting in the nursery. A whole basket full of Easter treats. Fred's getting desperate.
He's finding stuff too.
I really like there.
Obviously not.
Gee, by this time next year, Brett will be giving talks on Easter and on his mission instead of collecting candy. I'll have to send him a care package.
Yep.
He likes that idea. so cute.
Yeah,
no. No, I'm sure you don't. If you want to leave, I'll find out for sure, though. Saving the day. Here we go. Here we still are trying to build ourselves a nice road because it's not working. We're stuck. Everyone's getting a little stressed out and hot. And here's the mothership.
Don't do that. You'll break the camera.
Hi, mothership.
Personal
set. How do you feel about this?
I think that this was a great day for finding new stuff like kivas and like monkey huts with matates in the Cambrian State Found. But I don't think we'll ever come back here again because we've had a lot of problems on this whole trip.
Well, there you had it, folks.
Pardon the interruption, but I think Grandpa's taken off without you.
Steve, do you have a statement for us?
This is definitely the most amazing maneuver I've ever seen. How many people does it ever take to... I think we have 14 directors, only 2 workers, and 1 driver. But I gotta go home.
You are blown away.
I am. I gotta go.
There is Steve and Cambry ready to save the day, being the directors of the year. Okay, they've been, see this? This is a road that was just constructed. We're still on Monday, actually. Day of the Kiva and the Monkey Hut and the corn grinding stone. But this is a nightmare. To do this trip. We have been stuck so many times, pulled out the chain so many times, and we're going to pray that this works again. And another boulder takes the roll. This one right here. This one right here. Cambry and Steve are the official guiders.
All right, give them an 8.7 for style on that one. Wait, can you rewind it and tell us where it was again?
No, I don't know. Looks good there, though.
Yeah, we're decorating.
Nice to have you along, Steve.
What? Thanks. I'm really brought you along for a reason.
Is that the only reason?
Well, then.
We did.
You two are so cute.
Thanks. It's all her.
All right, let's see how Dad does.
Gonna give a little speech.
Okay, well, I can hear you, so are we having fun yet?
I would like to dedicate this moment to my posterity.
To your posterity, if indeed you live long enough to have one.
Those of you watching TV right now who cannot smell.
We have Groneman. This doesn't really look that bad here, but it's because cameras don't get the whole perspective. And this actually isn't the worst spot of road we've run into.
Drive on that, Steve! Drive on that!
What's that, Dad?
If I drive on that rock? No, you're good, because she's good right here.
Fun part. I don't think so.
Oh my gosh, you're going to trouble.
Go in or move. Yeah. Catch it. Another nightmare place. Here we go. Here we go. He's coming.
Last time
we put a little barbecue sauce on it, and it was good. Oh, I got those rolls left over from the steak sandwich tonight. Nice. Hey, we have barbecue sauce. You guys want to show us the barbecue? You came, might not get any. If we do, you guys are eating first. No problem there.
No problem at all.
I want to taste some.
There might not be any left for you if we do.
Oh, if we're the ones catching them, we're going to get the first spot. It's kind of like a rabbit, actually.
Have you had rabbit?
Yeah.
Well, you can say it tastes like chicken. Everything tastes like chicken.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, that's true. It is.
Everything tastes like chicken. I had rattlesnake meat once. It tastes
like chicken. Oh, you found one, did you, buddy?
No, I didn't.
Is that the same one?
No, I didn't find any.
There's not many of these things around here.
Oh, what about that one right out there, Kim?
Yeah, that one's probably a good one.
This first night we've been able to have a fire since we got here, and this is Wednesday. We've been here since Sunday. Last three nights we had bad winds.
Your daughter has never eaten snipe before.
We've never been hunting snipe.
Really?
No.
You're...
I haven't since I was a kid.
I can't believe you're falling down in your fatherly duties, dear, and teaching your children the basics.
Yeah, Dad.
I haven't taken them deer hunting. I rarely take them fishing.
Never, obviously, never.
I've never taken them snipe hunting.
Brianna, you've been abused.
You've never been deer hunting.
I know.
You know what the good thing about snipe hunting is, Sean? You don't need a license to do it. No, you better post the deer hunting or fishing.
You better be more patient, though, than when we went fishing. We go fishing, and we get out there in the boat, and I swear, we throw the lines over, and... I mean, I get theirs, by the time I get theirs all baited up and everything, throw it in, and then get mine all baited up, throw mine in. Sean's like, there's nothing here. You better be more patient, pal.
Well, you have to be patient with snipe. Real patient.
Sometimes it takes two or three drives before you can get them out.
You whack at the boat?
That would be good to have snipe tomorrow for dinner.
That's just what we were saying.
Yeah. Hey.
We just didn't decide which way, whether we want them fried or roasted.
We use sticks. If they, well, can they use those poles?
What, fry them on? Or over the fire?
No,
to drive them. Oh, yeah.
Sure.
Drive them, why not?
Perfect.
You better get you a couple before it gets dark. Pick you out a couple of
sticks. How many do we need?
Well, you'll need only two, because there'll be two drivers and one bag person.
Your children are too good.
Brianna can't wait to taste. I want to taste. She's going to
be so disappointed.
We're so cruel.
I got to get the cell phone so I can get Rachel on the phone.
We're so cruel.
I got to call Norma again, too. Kurt. I told her we'd go on Sunday and we won't be home until Monday.
Nope. Turned up. Get the bag.
There we go, finally.
Get your bag. Let me show you where you got to be.
This is the innovative way that we get in tents around here with broken zippers. And we have lots of tents with broken zippers in these parts. See, Grandma, go!
Got her best egg.
Kids are getting ready to go on their snipe plan.
You think these kids can do it by themselves? Or should we help them?
Well, they're going to have to learn to do it by themselves sooner or later.
Yeah, I hope it was the first time.
I'm not getting through now. Now it says I got four bars. What'd you do with my camera, Randy?
I put it back in your bag over there on the table.
Are they still coming out right now?
No, well, they may be out. Like I say, sometimes it takes one or two drives before you can get them out.
Oh, yeah.
Can they just dig holes in the ground or something?
Yeah.
They live in the bushes and the trees.
Don't rip your bag.
They're hard to see. Because they blend right in with the background.
That's why you have to beat the bushes.
So, do we just hit the bushes and trees?
Yeah.
So, where are they?
I've got Ian.
From that way.
Ian's out there.
Do you guys really hunt snipe? Yes.
Do you want to get a snipe tonight or not?
I like snipe. It's good eating.
Sean doesn't want it. I'll do that.
I love it.
You want me to do it? They don't want to do it.
Snipe. You guys help us.
It's so tender.
I know.
We'll help you.
Come on, then. I like it.
Let's see these guys if they can do it first. before we get involved.
Right down in there, over behind my tent.
Brianna, go with him.
Just kind of beat the brush. You might not see him, but just kind of
stay about 10 feet apart. We're holding them in on this side, so.
Do you think they'll come around
with this
smoke
and
everything?
I think we ought to.
We'll try it.
Kind of go right over behind the
tent. Behind the tent, guys.
Because you guys will kind of hold them in on this side.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll get them here. We will.
We will, or we'll starve tomorrow.
The only ones are ready, so we can start calling.
Kurt? Tell us when you're ready, so we can start calling them.
Need to get up to the movie this or
yeah, you're very movie.
Down, sorry.
I think I see one going.
Ian, here comes one.
Watch it, he's coming. They're fast, you really have to watch them.
I saw one too. Didn't you see that one that went by?
I think he missed it.
Oh, I'm probably going to have to do it again.
Ian, you got to jump out in front of them when they're coming.
I didn't see it.
Does somebody else want to do the snipe bag?
I will.
Okay. Can you make the snipe sound?
That was there.
A little higher pitch. There you go.
That's better.
Round two.
Now that one ran really fast. I saw it. So be prepared, Brianna.
Oh, I saw it for a second over there, but I didn't see it over here.
Randy or Kim, you show where to start this thing.
Ian,
Sean, come on.
Come over this way so you're not
hurry,
this fast.
Hurry.
Come around. Don't go back where you came.
We won't go back.
Hey, come this way. This way. Boys, this way. Towards us.
Over here, by the fire.
You don't want...
Okay, have her start calling them.
Okay, get ready.
Get your bag.
Okay. Put the bag down. Opening of the bag down.
Get it down there. That's the way.
Go. Go.
No,
wishes.
By cruel perpetrators.
Just stay there, Brianna. They might come yet. Duck down and start calling them.
I am not telling you any more things. Anymore.
All right, I don't think we're going to catch one tonight.
That's because there is no such thing as a snipe.
Oh, come on.
Where'd you stick that?
Where'd you
taste them and see if there's any such a thing, boy?
If you guys are so smart, then you guys catch them. Why you come show us how? We don't know what they look like.
Well, the thing about it is, John,
where do we go? Too close. Can't see where I'm going.
I see one coming! Did you catch him?
Get that one? No.
Oh.
Well, you guys are some
these
teachers.
Guys are great.
Hunters. What's in front of you?
Try again tomorrow night. They're spooked now. They're spooked.
The mighty hunters return.
No.
Didn't get your game, huh?
I got fired. What? we've tried for three tonight.
Doesn't
want to
wait till tomorrow.
Huh?
Doesn't want to wait till tomorrow.
Well, there's food now.
I don't think there's any more in there.
Did I have my sweatshirt on when I went down to the shower?
You what?
Did I have my sweatshirt on when I went?
Go!
I might have to
get a picture of Kirk tonight.
Oh, yes.
This might come back to haunt him. Okay, here they come.
Get ready, Kurt. They're
here
coming.
Here comes Kurt. There he is.
Kurt,
get him.
Get him. Oh, God!
Let's clip that second.
Good.
Here, put him right down here. Put him right down here. Put him right down here.
Get him. Get him. Get him. Get him. Get him.
Are you still wiggling?
Yeah.
Show him that. I think you got
him. I think you got him. Let's fry that puppy up.
He's not still alive.
No,
he's alright. He's there. Okay. Yeah. Grab him. No! I caught it! Oh, my God!
Yeah!
Nice! Nice! Nice!
I
knew this whole thing.
Oh, you knew it all along. Yeah. Of course, I kneeled down right in the cactus.
We've all been snipe hunting.
He said that it tasted good.
Ouch. Yeah, I see that one. They do. They taste just like kind of plastic leather.
Exactly.
That wasn't fun.
We got one.
We got one, yeah.
Why don't you guys all hold up the snipe you caught?
Let's take a picture of the snipe. Hold it up, yeah.
Help me out.
Oh, no, you've got to be there too.
Help me out.
No way.
Guys.
Help me out.
No, stand over there on the other side of the fire.
Yeah. Both of you hold it together.
All of you
hold it together. Come on, Brianna, get up there.
Wow.
Come on.
Okay.
Wow.
Sean,
can I do
John,
this, Sean?
John.
Everybody put a hand on it.
Everybody put a hand on it.
Wow.
Wow! You're not taking any pictures.
I might put my camera away.
Question number 19. What is Alyssa's favorite movie? Favorite movie? Okay.
I can put it down to a few, and then we'll try to narrow it down to one. So, like Emma, Sense and Sensibility, and Pride and Prejudice. Let's say Emma.
All right. The new version of Imagine.
Yeah. All right.
Gwyneth Paltrow.
Yeah.
Great show. All right. What is Tom's favorite movie?
Oh, my favorite movie. Right
Emma,
now,
sure.
I know. Yeah, it's Emma. Emma all the time when she wants to watch it. You know what I've been dying to see? It's my favorite movie this week.
All right.